To apply several formats in one step and to make sure that cells have consistent formatting, you can use what we call a cell style. A cell style is defined as a set of formatting characteristics such as fonts, font sizes, number formats, cell borders, and more. So Excel has several built-in cell styles that you can apply or modify, and you can also create your own custom cell styles. So let's first look into some built-in styles in Excel that you can use. So let's first select all these cells here, go to the Styles section in the Home tab and click on this down arrow, and you can see all these built-in cell style that you can choose. So let's choose for example this one, 60% accent 6, and let's apply also a different cell style, for example for the totals column. Go to the Styles section, click on the down arrow, and for this I will choose this blue accent 5, and I will choose the same cell style also for this totals row, click on accent 5. Moreover, we can use cell styles in order to format numbers. So here we have the total sales numbers, and we don't know the currency of this total sales, maybe in dollars, in euro, in pounds, and etc. So we select all these numbers, go to the styles, and here we can choose the currency. And you can see when we move our mouse pointer over the currency, we have this dollar sign next to each number, and we have two decimal places for each number. Moreover, at cell E16, we have this comma which acts as a thousands separator. And in order, if you want to remove the decimal places, you can always choose this currency 0, and this will remove the decimal places from each number. So let's choose this one, for example. Also, I will try to use cell style to format this title. So I will choose this cell A2, go to the styles, hit the down arrow, and here we have cell styles related to titles and headings. So let's choose, for example, heading number 4. And now you know how to use some built-in cell styles. For example, let's see how to create our own custom-made cell styles. So to do this, we need first to format a given cell, for example. So we select cell A5, go to the font section in the Home tab, and choose this this dark gray color, and for the font color I will choose the white color. Now with this cell selected, go to the Style section, click on this down arrow, and click on New Cell Style, and here you can give it a name. So I will give it the name cell A. And you can see that this style includes these items: number format, alignment, font, border, fill, protection. And you can uncheck any formatting that you don't want. So for example, we don't want this cell style to include some number formatting. So let's uncheck the first button. So let's hit OK. And you can you can select all these cells and click on the cell style, the custom made cell style named cell A, and all these cells will be formatted with this cell style. Now let's say you want to change something in the formatting of this cell style. So you can right click on this cell A and click on modify, and you can click on this format button. So this will open the format cells dialog box. So let's start with the font. I will change the font, for example, to Cambria. I will change the color to a black color. I will add some borders here, click on the outline, and change the background color to a dark orange color, and let's hit on OK and OK. And you can see that all the cells that are related to this cell style will automatically change their format. So this is a powerful advantage of using cell styles. So you don't need to manually change the format of each cell. So you just need to change the cell style's characteristics, and the cells related to this cell style will automatically change. Okay, so now if you need, for example, to know which cell style is applied to a given cell, for example. So let's select this cell, A4. And if you want to search for the cell style applied, it will be a little bit difficult because you need to find a cell style with some gray border surrounding it. And you can see this gray border surrounding the 60% accent 6. So this is a little bit hard to see, but you need to search for it. And let's repeat, for example, for another cell. So cell A16. And click here, and you can see here this gray border surrounding accent 5. Now there is of course another easier way to do this. You can select a cell, for example, and then hold on the Alt key and press the single quotation mark on your keyboard, and this will open this menu, and you can read the style name from here. So this is 60% accent 6. So let's choose another one here and hold on the Alt key and the single quotation mark, and you can read the style name easily from here instead of just going to the built-in styles and reading from this styles menu. Okay, so this is an easier way. Now let's say we want to use this custom created cell style into another workbook. So we keep this workbook open. You go to File, Open, and Browse, then open this Merge Styles workbook, double click on it, and for the Merge Styles workbook, if you click on this down arrow, you will not find the custom made cell style, so we need to import it to this workbook. So to import it, click on this down arrow and then click on Merge Styles and choose Cell Styles, the previously this opened workbook, the previous one that we created Cell A style name in it. So Merge Styles from cellstyles.xlsx and click OK. Now Merge styles that have the same name, so we don't want to do this. So let's hit this no button, and you can see that we have imported the custom made cell style into this workbook, and we can use it. So you can, for example, select these cells and just apply it here. Now you know how to apply some built-in cell styles or create your own custom made cell styles. Apply these techniques in order to create some consistent formatting across all your worksheets.